love that one over there. That's beautiful.
Good luck.
Thank you. Uh-huh.
We'll travel around the country helping one deserving family in each and every of the 50 states. Week, we're in Kentucky, and the renovation starts right now.
So Paul, Michael, Dee, and Eduardo, we are driving through Louisville, Kentucky on our way to meet the Hughes family. It is Patrick John, Patricia, Patrick Henry, Jesse, and Cameron. Now, Patrick Henry is a very special kid. He was born with disabilities, but he hasn't let that stop him from reaching his goals and his dreams. This is truly one of the most inspiring stories you guys will ever hear. Take a look at this tape.
Hi, ABC! We're the Hughes family from Louisville, Kentucky!
And I'm the mom.
I'm Patrick John, and I'm the dad.
I'm Patrick Henry, and I'm 19 years old.
I'm Patrick's younger brother, Jesse. I'm 16.
And I'm Cameron, the 12-year-old.
After Patrick John and Patricia got married, they knew they wanted to start a family right away. Within a year, they were expecting their first child. It had been a normal pregnancy with no complications.
So we're about to experience the birth of my first son. I'm as excited as any 26-year-old man would be. Looked like a normal delivery to me, looked like a normal baby, you know. And I remember hearing one of the doctors use the term multiple anomalies. Something just didn't feel right about the whole thing.
Patrick Henry was born with some major disabilities. He was born without eyes and without the ability to straighten his arms and legs.
It was hard. I kind of went off on my own, basically cried all night long, thinking of all the things that he wouldn't be able to do.
It was almost like a funeral. Millions of dreams we had for our son died. There were some nights of crying ourselves to sleep and asking, you know, God, you know, why us? Why did you do this to us? We each, I think, sort of came to the realization that, okay, this is what we've been handed. Now let's get to work. I'm going to give him as full a life and all of the opportunities that I would give an able-bodied son.
We just put him out in front of people and pushed him to be outgoing and didn't dwell on any of the handicaps. I think Patrick didn't realize he was blind until he was in preschool. He could focus on the positive of himself and get on with life.
His dad, Patrick John, took a job working nights so he could care for Patrick Henry during the day.
He went through a handful of surgeries. I don't remember if it was 4 or 5 or 6. We did a permanent implant. He now has glass eyes, so people that look at him looks like he has eyes.
Patrick John figured that since he'd never be able to play ball with his son, they could at least play music together. So at 9 months, Patrick Henry started playing the piano, and by the time he was 2, he was taking requests.
Can you play You Are My Sunshine?
His arms, he can't straighten out 180 degrees, which makes his piano playing all the more incredible because he doesn't have a full range of motion in his arms. With all of Patrick's problems and disabilities, I didn't know what sort of bond we would have, but here it was forming right in front of me.
Patrick Henry's world quickly evolved around music. He plays the piano, the trumpet, and he writes his own music.
I started doing some piano performances around the community, and everyone seemed to enjoy it. Of course, I always just thought it was a natural thing. I can play piano. I'm sure everyone can play some sort of music.
So it was only natural that when he started the University of Louisville, he wanted to join the marching band.
I'm Dr. Greg Byrne. I'm the director of the University of Louisville Marching Band in Louisville, Kentucky. I invited Patrick Hughes to be in the marching band. I saw Patrick as a trumpet player, not as a kid in a wheelchair that's blind.
I was a little nervous about it at first. You wonder how the other students are going to accept not only Patrick Henry into the band, but will they accept Mr. Hughes coming along as well?
Guys, here's the thing that's amazing about this family. Patrick John joined the band with his son. He pushes Patrick Henry's wheelchair through all the band formations for both practice and the games.
Seeing my dad and my brother in the marching band is so cool because
They work together. Patrick learns the music, and Dad learns all the steps to get Patrick to where he needs to be. And they usually don't mess up.
It's funny, people always, you know, talk about all that I sacrifice for Patrick Henry. But to me, it's not a sacrifice. I consider Patrick my hero, my personal hero. It's an absolute blessing that I wonder if I'm even deserving of.
The only thing working against this family right now is their house. As Patrick Henry gets older and more independent, it's really difficult for him to move around his house. His family does their best to assist him, but their house just doesn't work for their son.
This room is kind of an obstacle course. There's a lot of things I might bump into, and once I get to the couches, I get out of my wheelchair and push the wheelchair after me while I crawl up the ramp.
We've made the house comfortable for the family, but obviously for Patrick, makes him a prisoner in this house rather than a resident.
If the house was accessible for him, that he could, you know, cook, you know, use the bathroom and move from room to room and feel safe and not have to depend on someone to be there with him, it would just be tremendous for him.
Music has been so amazing and miraculous to me. It's given me a great connection to life, and God made me blind and unable to walk. Big deal. With music, I know that I can do anything I set my mind to.
His message is incredible, and certainly he deserves, I'm embarrassed to say, more than I've been able to provide at this point. If there's anybody that deserves an opportunity to experience independence in its greatest mode, it's Patrick Henry.
That would be great.
I mean, this kid is truly incredible, man, and like he has not let anything stop him. But Patrick needs a house that actually works for him, that's not such a struggle, and we can change that.
Yep.
So what do you say? We make this happen?
Oh, yeah.
Bring it in, people. Let's make it happen. Are you with me?
Okay.
Well, then let's do it! John, Patricia, Patrick Henry, Jesse, and Cameron. Come on! Hey! What's happening? How are you? Hi!
Oh my goodness!
You need some help?
Got it.
Hey!
It's Ty.
How you doing?
Hey, good to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm glad to be here.
Oh, you're going to meet everybody.
Nice to meet you.
How are you?
Doing great. How about you?
I think people see people with disabilities and they judge them, and that's cruel. Look at Patrick Henry. He's amazing. He plays in the band. He plays instruments, and you see what life has dealt him and how he's given it back. It's pretty impressive.
Patrick Henry, what do you think, man? Are you glad we're here?
Oh, yes, very much so. I've been looking forward to this for the longest time.
I bet you guys would love to know where you're going on vacation, wouldn't you?
That'd be great.
Well, I'm not going to tell you yet. But I tell you what, it is going to be awesome, but I'm going to save that for later. So, actually, Dad, if Patrick Henry and you guys will show me the house, we'll get this thing started.
Although Patrick Henry was born without the ability to see and with limited physical mobility, his father, Patrick Sr., has become his eyes and his legs. He does face certain challenges that a lot of other 19-year-olds don't face. His ability to live independently is much more difficult, so we're here this week to give him the independence that he deserves.
Wow. So
it takes a perfect shot to get through there, but we usually make it.
And you got
to
scratch against the door just
going
in.
Well, you can see all the woodwork we've chewed up in the door.
Wow. So just getting in here is difficult enough.
Yes, it is.
Okay, so here we go. So this is the kitchen?
Yes.
You ever help out cooking?
I've tried to persuade my mom for the longest time to teach me how to cook, but our kitchen appliances aren't really accessible for me to get up to, so she's always said no. So
he can't get his wheelchair underneath anything to get close enough to be able to even attempt to learn to cook on his own.
The main concerns with the house is his mobility. The kitchen, he can't really even use because there's not enough room in there. Everything hits, if there's an oven down or a door open, he can't even get by. Every doorway, there's scratches because that's his wheelchair scratch. And just to get through there, it's so narrow, he can barely get to go anywhere. This house is a very, very much a problem for all of them, but especially for Patrick Henry.
So this is the bathroom?
Yes, this is the bathroom.
What are some of the problems you have with the bathroom? I mean, you've got some issues with this thing?
Yes.
I guess the main issue would be getting in and out of the bathtub.
Is there any way you could kind of show me what happened?
Sure, I'd be happy to. We can take him like this.
Oh.
And then set him on the edge, and he kind of scoots himself down in there from here. And then he'll, you know, he'll twist himself around and lay down. And then we
pick him up and put him back in his chair.
So that's, and my wife does the same thing too, which, much as a struggle as it is for me, I watch her do it, and it just amazes me.
Yeah.
That she is still capable. So,
the bathroom is an absolute nightmare. Mom and Dad are getting older. At some point, they're not going to be able to lift him into the bathtub, which is really, really kind of scary because he can be dropped, especially when he's wet. I think we showed up at the right time to give these guys what they need.
Okay, Dee Dee, this is my room.
Nice, I like it.
This is actually my brother's bed, Cameron, and we share a room.
You share this space together?
Yes, we share.
So this is kind of like his room, and
this split line right here, you know, two-thirds mine, one-third his.
Right on.
I've never actually had my own room, so I'd like to know what that's like.
How do you imagine your room to be?
I don't know. I'd really like a room devoted to...
Jesse is the middle child. He's 16, and he's into photography. Jesse is just a growing young man that needs his own space, so I'm going to give that to him this week.
This is my family room. It's also known as the music room because it's got a bunch of guitars and a piano in it.
Gotcha.
And I can play the guitar and the drums.
And are those your two favorite instruments?
Yes.
So what kind of music do you like?
I like 70s rock.
Do you 70s rock? Is there anybody specific you like?
Elvis.
Nice, nice. Now, I wasn't alive in the 70s, but it would be very, very cool. I love the 70s, too. So now, do you play anything?
Yeah.
It's great for me when you ask somebody what do they like in their room, and they say, I like a 70s rock room. Okay, that's what you like, a 70s rock room? Here it comes.
Give me the Elvis.
So, first of all, I just want to say that I'm very excited about meeting you.
Oh, it's a pleasure to meet you as well.
So let me ask you a question, because you really seem to have an incredibly positive outlook on life. What, I mean, is there a motto you live by?
I'm gonna share a couple of things with you. I see blindness not as a disability, but more an ability. And sight, actually, more as a disability. Because some people with sight tend to judge others by what they see on the outside. Whereas I don't see that. I just see that which is within a person. And you hear all the different color adjectives, black, white, red, yellow. Those have no meaning to me whatsoever. I just see that which is within a person.
That's pretty amazing. Pretty awesome. I mean, what you just said is actually quite beautiful, man. You're such an inspiration. Just the outlook you have in life in general. You know, a lot of people that don't even have the same obstacles you have don't even have that kind of a positive outlook in life. So it really says a lot about who you are inside as well as out.
Thank you very much.
So tell me about your dad, man. What's your relationship with your dad like?
Well, my relationship with Dad is very, very wonderful. It's actually a funny story. Both of us actually draw inspiration from each other. Because I must confess, there are days that I don't want to go to marching band rehearsal because it's been such a long day already, or whatever the case may be.
Sure.
But then I think what Dad did is go on just 4 or 5 hours of sleep a night, and I get a full night's sleep, so there's no reason for me to complain.
Is there anything you'd like to do for the band and the people that have been?
The field is a mess. It's a swamp, really.
Oh, wow. So this field that you're talking about, you think you could show me that? Maybe we could see about fixing it up?
Sure, I guess so. It's at U of L.
Okay, we'll get your dad and we'll take a ride over there.
You know, a lot of times you focus on someone's disability, but I think this week is really focused on their ability. You may think that some person can't do something because of
whether they can't see or they can't walk, but you forget that maybe they can do something you can't even do. And Patrick Henry has a talent not only musically, but he has, I think, a talent spiritually in the sense that he can feel life. And, you know, he's desperately trying to be as independent as he can. What's really great about this week is that we can give him back some of that independence so that his life completely changes and becomes so much easier, not only for him, but for his whole family.
Forward march.
Very good. Let's go.
The marching band field. Let's hit it.
Coming up next.
I've been doing this for 31 years, and trust me, we haven't done it like this before.
Patrick does not dwell on his disabilities. He is a shining example of perseverance and what you can do.
I composed this next song that I would like to do for you.
I just hope this story can inspire just one person, if not hundreds.
This week, it's not so much about building a house, it's about making someone's life easier. This is what you call a very special family, and I think Patrick Henry not only inspires his family, but I think he inspires everyone he meets.
I couldn't believe that all those people would come to see me, you know. I'm just a guy, just an ordinary guy living my life.
Practice with the band on, right?
Yes, it is.
The field.
So we're here to build the Hughes family a house. So you're the band leader, right?
Yes, sir.
I've heard a lot about you, man.
Well, we've heard a lot about you for sure. Welcome to the University of Louisville.
We're glad to be here. So here's what I'd like to do. Can you guys show us some moves?
Oh, absolutely. Let's get the show on the road.
So when we pull up, we're actually on the practice field. The band is there. They're rehearsing. I meet Greg, who's actually the band director, really super nice guy who loves Patrick Henry and his whole family. And as I looked around, I realized this is a huge part of Patrick Henry's life. And I think we ought to be able to make not only his life at home easier, but also his life on the practice field.
But I think the field you're on could use a little work. So here's the thing. We're helping out Patrick's family, but we're also going to make over this field. So everybody listen. Grab your instruments, grab your stuff. Looks like you're taking a week off. And when you come back,
what an incredible moment. Not only was our home going to get a makeover, but that the marching band field was going to get a makeover. And to see the 220 other members of the band celebrate, it was such a nice feeling, you know, to be able to make the marching band part of the makeover as well and give back a little bit there.
And you look at children that have disabilities and it seems like they'd be sad or get depressed. You don't see that with him.
He really hasn't had very many bad days. I mean, we try to make it easy as possible for Patrick, but we do want him to live in the real world. I mean, he has to know that there are difficulties out there, and there's people that probably judge him from what they see. And mm-hmm. and we could have did the self-pity route. We chose not to.
Now, what about the independence of Patrick and the future?
He wants to be independent. He wants to not have to wait for us to take him from his room to the front door and out the door without having to worry about falling down steps or a little landing, or and I always have that fear, and it's just a mother thing, I'm sure. I mean, he keeps telling me, you know, I'm 19, Mom, I'm an adult, I can, you know, I'm okay. And I was like, I don't know, but what if?
Right.
And so hopefully, and especially with you guys here, that Patrick can be on his own and be safe in his own home.
The goal is so that Patricia doesn't have to worry about her son, but let's face it, she's a mom. She's always going to worry about her son, but I think a lot of that will be lifted from her. She's an amazing lady, too, because she works so hard. She takes care of Patrick Henry nonstop, and part of this week is about rewarding these amazing parents.
Hi!
How's everything going over here?
Great, great. We got to get you guys off to vacation.
Okay. All right!
I bet you want to know where you're going now, don't you?
Yes!
Well, I've got two surprises for you. The first surprise is you guys are going to London, England! Oh, yeah. Disney Vacation Club is sending you guys to London, England.
Yes!
Now, here's the second surprise. Your second surprise is I'm sending you with a tour guide.
Well, I hope you're ready for a vacation! We're gonna go on vacation!
Patrick Henry has always wanted to go to London, and being able to go to London with my family to have a vacation with the five of us together is so exciting. I can't wait. I mean, Ed's from London, so he has all the inside track of all the exciting things we could be doing. It's gonna be so exciting.
Are you guys ready to go to London, England?
Yeah!
This is what you call a very special family, and I think they are an example of things we could all learn from. And Patrick Henry and the way he is as a person not only inspires his family, but I think he inspires everyone he meets. I guess for me, this week, it's not so much about building a house. It's about making someone's life easier. And what's really neat is this week I might be able to make that happen.
So there's our team. I want you to meet Joe and Rocky from Elite Homes, and this is their team.
All right.
The family is not going to believe this. So what do you say we get the family on board and let them know what's happening?
Yeah. Hello, Queenie. Hello, sweetheart. How you doing? It's Ed. Yeah, I'm outside. You're at the third window. Guys, wait, it's at the top there. Yeah, just what, I'm with the family. Can we come in? It's freezing out here. Can we come in for a cup of tea? You're busy, family meeting.
Hello, Hughes family. And Ed.
Party time!
Woo! Guys, I hope you're having a fantastic time in London. It's gonna take a lot to get you guys in a new house in 7 days. And there are a few people who are going to make that happen, and they'd like to say hi. Say hi, everybody! Hey, everyone!
I think the entire town of Louisville is out here today.
Now, there's also two guys I want you to meet. This is Rocky and Joe from Elite Homes. They're going to be the builders this week and make sure you guys are in a quality home. So, before we get started, I'm sure you want to say something to the team, right?
Yeah. I want to thank everybody for coming out here today.
Patrick Hughes and his family have touched and change the lives of people all over this country. This week, we have the privilege to touch and change their lives. The Hughes family, they've had a dream that one day they'll have a home that Patrick won't be imprisoned in. They won't have to get on the floor and crawl to the next room and drag his wheelchair behind him. They have a dream that he'll live in a home without obstructions, that he'll have some privacy, that he'll be able to be independent. This week, we're going to make that dream come true.
Thing about demo, you know, it's a very exciting thing and we want the family to be able to see it, but in this case Patrick Henry can't. We want him to be able to feel it, so we thought we'd bring in kind of a musical experience for him to really understand what's happening with demo.
Just for you.
I think you're gonna love this.
I hear music. I hear laughter. Every time I hear a song.
Play it, boys.
The best part. Wait till you see this.
Last night, I hear a melody play. Suddenly, I take flight.
Oh, look at the window. The
windows are shaking.
Oh, my house.
Incredible.
This is what I call demolition in motion.
Woo!
Let's do this.
Someone you know deserves a home makeover. Go to abc.com, keyword home makeover, to apply to be on the show.
Good morning. It's the morning of day three. As you can see, we got
this right here will be the entry, dining room right over here, nice, wide, beautiful kitchen right in this area over here.
This week we're building 3,300 square feet. It'll all be on one floor, and this house is so Kentucky. It's that southern charm, lots and lots of brickwork with shutters and white columns. It's going to be beautiful.
One of the most important things we're doing this week is this right here, wide hallways and wide doors. If you remember the old house, all the hallways and the doorways were chewed up in Patrick Henry's wheelchair. Well, that's not going to happen in this house.
All right, this is one of three desks that I'm building for Jesse's room. This is going to house his computer, the printer, and the photo scanner. And I really think it's going to help Jesse build as a photographer.
This week, I'm doing Jesse's room. It is going to be the professional photography room. I don't know if he's going to leave. I'm putting in a photo booth, which is insane. I mean, who has a photo booth in their room? So I think he's just going to be going wow, 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 and more wows. It's going to be amazing.
These guys are going to be set up in front of his camera, and it's going to add a real cool atmosphere to the section of the room. These can be set up, and Jesse can actually use them to actually put things on to shoot, and I think it's going to be really cool.
All this stuff I need to do in Cameron's room, so I asked some of the guys, what do you say we put what we need to do into a song? And so we did, a little blues number called Cameron's Room.
Walk, dirty dog, got the guitar on the floor. Drums, sticks on the bed, guitar picks overhead. 400 drumsticks just to make his desk. This young man ain't gonna get no rest. But when you hear that Elvis groove, you know you'll be rocking in Cameron's room. Everybody's rocking in Cameron's room, Cameron's room, Cameron's room. Everybody rocking in Cameron's room.
That's the idea. What do you think? We can do it?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, let's get busy.
I'm working on the interior design right now for the great room. And for starters, I picked this beautiful dark wood for the hardwood floors. I'm going to work that back to two different stains for the kitchen cabinets, this cream and the dark, which looks great together, all tied together with this granite, which is beautiful. For fabrics, I've got gold and the brown and this paisley, which has this little bit of sage green. So I'm going to use this paint right here to work back to that. I think this is going to be perfect for the Hughes family. It's rich, it's classic, and very southern.
Okay, so dude, I'm so glad you're gonna take on this project. Here's the really cool news. The school's actually giving me this field, which is so much better. It's right across from the old Patrick's field. But it's more level, and I think it'll really work out for Patrick's wheelchair better. But obviously, this still needs a lot of work, so I'm hoping you've got a plan together.
I actually do. Check this out. Look at this awesome plan. Whole new field here, Louisville on the sides. We've got the Cardinals logo.
Yes.
You know, some new lights, got a covered area for Patrick Henry and his friends, and it's raining.
For some shade.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that'd be great. Awesome.
I just need some help, dude. I can do this by myself.
Oh, I can get you help.
Yeah?
Come on in, people! Come on in! I think you're gonna do all right with
it. That's great!
Being here, this is going to make a huge difference for Patrick and actually everybody that goes to the school, because this is going to be a great practice field for the band. We've got a lot of work to do, not only in the house, but also in this field. You guys ready to help? Yeah! What do you say? Let's do it! Let's make it happen! Kentucky, and these parts, they build houses out of brick, white brick, and we're going to use over 20,000 of these bricks on the Hughes family home, so we better get started.
Okay, this is
Jesse's photography room, and I had to come in and check to see if all the lights are in the right places, and it looks amazing. These are great cans. We've got some good positions for some electricity outlets, because this is where I want to run the trusses. They're going to come out about 4 feet by 4 feet, so he can hang different lighting, because every photographer needs good lighting.
All right, so I was very serious about this big guitar that's going to be sitting in the floor in Cameron's room. This is the form. Concrete's going to be poured all around this, except in here, which is really cool. So this will all be filled with different guitar parts. Right up here will be the neck, you know, the part where you use your left hand. So there's the guitar, pretty much actual size.
Okay, probably wondering why I'm in a music store. Well, this family, especially Patrick Henry, are all about music. So I came here to get inspired and check out all these musical instruments. How can you not be inspired? And the one thing I gotta remember while I'm designing Patrick Henry's room is it's not so much what you see, but it's what you hear.
So wherever we go, I always try to find a local artist who can give a little local flavor to the family's home. It's a wonderful man in here named Jesse. I'm so excited to meet him. Hi, I'm looking for Jesse.
Hey, this is him.
Jesse, I'm Michael. And you are?
My name is Joe Scott.
Hi, Joe.
And I'm Jesse's interpreter.
So Jesse is blind?
Yes, and he has been deaf for most of his life.
And he's an artist.
Yes, he is.
I met Jesse, who is an artist, but he's blind, and he's deaf, and he can't speak. I met his interpreter as well, who told me that this man wants to create all the time. He sews plastic bags together. He sews fabrics together. It's all about touch. It's about tactile things. So you've got a smooth texture next to a rough texture, and it's quite phenomenal. But the reason that I'm here today is that we're building a home this week for a very special family, the Hughes family, and their oldest son, Patrick Henry, is he's blind, and he also has some other disabilities. And I've heard about Jesse and what he does, and if he'd be interested in sharing some art with us, it would be so special to us.
Michael, he's been working on another piece, a very special piece that he would like to donate. It is over here if you'd like to take a look at it.
He offered one of his quilts that he makes, and I'm going to hang it right outside Patrick Henry's door. It's something that he can touch and feel, and I think it's inspiring for him to know that a man who's 75 years old, who is blind, deaf, and can't speak, creates beautiful things. He doesn't know what these fabrics look like, he just knows how they feel. And I think it just is inspiring for Patrick Henry.
View of one of the columns. Here's the front view, two columns of the archway. Now this is going to be the grand entrance to the practice field for the marching band.
I was with the marching band when I was in high school, so I realized how important this experience is, not only to Patrick Henry, but to all of the people that march in the band with him. So I'm really excited to work on this project.
So it's going to be about 16 feet high. There's going to be 18 feet across between these two columns. It's going to be fabulous. Well, we only have a few days to do it, so I need you guys to work hard and get this done.
Yeah,
deal?
No problem.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Everybody say, we want to move to London.
We want to move to London.
You liars.
Hello, this is Patrick.
Hey, Patrick. Hello, Hughes family, man. How is London?
Oh, Ty, we're having a wonderful time.
I'm so glad you guys made it there safely. Now, listen, I know Patrick Henry really loves theater. So you guys are going to go to the West End Theater District, and you're actually going to go see The Lion King.
Oh, that's fantastic. Good. All right, Ty just said we're seeing. Are you ready?
Yes.
The Lion King.
Yes! All right!
You guys can get to go backstage. You'll get to meet the guys in the cast. You guys have fun, and I'll talk to you soon.
All right, Ty. Thank you.
All right, bye, guys. Now that ought to be a lot of fun.
Okay, Hughes family, we ready?
Yes!
Let's go and see The Lion King.
All right!
I want to introduce you to Richard. He's a general manager of The Lion King.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Good to meet you too. I'd like to introduce you to three of our leading cast members.
Okay.
This is Linda Way, who plays Rafiki.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Does it make noise when you click?
Yeah, it does.
Cool.
Going to The Lion King was lots of fun. I loved the movie so much as a little kid that I had a lot of the characters as imaginary friends, and sometimes I'd dream about meeting the particular characters, but being able to touch the costumes in reality was really something.
Everyone comes into the theater at 6:15 for a vocal warm-up. I don't know whether there's a possibility you might assume the mantle of temporary music director for part of our vocal call this evening, because we...
Cool.
When I was asked to warm up with the cast, it was kind of scary at first because I wasn't expecting it. I didn't know what to do. Dad just had me do some stuff that my high school choir director taught me.
Opportunity for Patrick to perform on stage, on that very stage in that beautiful theater. Yeah, I don't know if words can describe it. It was like a dream.
You got work, face guy. Join in too. You can sing.
Say, mama, don't you treat me wrong.
This kid play, he's just soaring. The emotion in his face. The actors were just in awe. He's an amazing talent. He can sing and play the piano. Possibly one of the most amazing piano players I've ever had the pleasure of seeing.
In extreme situations, and as you can see, there's a lot going on here. The whole town have come together for the Hughes family. So I'm taking some pictures for Jesse's room, so I hope he can actually develop himself and see what's been going on here today.
Rocky, and what do you think about an entire state coming together to support not just the family, but to support Elite Homes in what you're doing here?
It is so heartwarming to know that all these people are willing to come out here and pour out this kind of effort 24 hours a day, right through the night, in order to see the smile on the family's face when they get home. I mean, it is so neat, and I've been doing this for 31 years, and trust me, we haven't done it like this before.
No, it's pretty cool. You're one of a few group of folks who can say you've built a house in 7 days.
You see all this commotion going on, all these people, it's great.
Go get them busy. I'll talk to you later.
Good to see you,
Jerry.
So you guys are all in the marching band, I understand.
Yes.
What is it like with Patrick Henry?
It's great.
It's really neat because we can play a song once and he can play it right after that. He picks up on it after one time.
You know, Patrick's blind and in a wheelchair, but you're on a marching band field, it doesn't matter because he's got a set of eyes and a set of legs and his dad.
I had the opportunity to spend some time with Patrick Henry's bandmates, Gabby and David and Joel, and what struck me was how moved they were by him. Patrick Henry touches everybody he comes in contact to, and that's a blessing.
Is there anything special as far as an instrument goes that we could give Patrick Henry?
I think a new trumpet would be kind of cool. That'd be a you know, one thing that he'd really like.
Awesome. Probably using a new wheelchair too. The one he has now, the wheels don't work on the field.
Okay, got it. So trumpet and an all-terrain type wheelchair.
Yeah.
Thank you guys so much for coming out and hanging out. You guys want to go check out the house?
Yeah.
All right, come on, let's check it out.
Band practice for Patrick Henry has always been challenging, especially dealing with an uneven field. But now we have a brand new field that is all level, and we're actually going to put some lines in it as well so the band can practice their formations and spacing.
This week, as part of my project of refurbishing the practice field for the marching band, we are doing a whole bunch of things. We're giving them new lights, we're giving them some new storage for all of their equipment, a sheltered area where Patrick Henry and his friends can actually take shelter if it gets too hot or if it starts raining, and a brand new sign that'll welcome them when they come to practice.
Hi, a ticket to Nashville, please.
Yes, what time's your flight today?
11 o'clock, I think.
Okay. I got you all set. That's going to board on B-15. Thank you. Have a nice flight.
For Cameron's Music Room, where do you want to go? You want to go to a place that knows a lot about music. Music capital of the world is Nashville, so off to Nashville I went. So here I am in Nashville, the source of where guitars are made for Cameron. Cameron loves guitars, and no one does it better than Gibson. So I got to go make guitars. I worked in all processes of making the guitars, from cutting out on the bandsaw the first part of the body of a guitar. I got to put electronics in the electric guitars. I got to string the electric guitars. I got to paint the electric guitars.
Each guitar is different, hand done, each one. Mine is going to be much different than Ray's.
One of my favorite things is I got to test the finished product. There's a lot that goes into making guitars, and it's like a kid in the candy factory store.
Okay, so I'm doing the kitchen, my special project. You're obviously doing the kitchen in the house.
Yep.
Like a race.
Okay.
So normally, you know, we...
Interest.
So Joe, Ted, this snake camp, we're going to be able to go through there and spy in on Ty, right?
Yeah.
All right. Hook me up.
Let me hear, Ted.
So I'm working on Patrick Henry's room. Now, texture is really a key element, not only because he can feel things, but also for his mobility. So I actually use bamboo flooring for two reasons. It's a renewable resource, and it's also very smooth, very hard, so that his wheelchair can actually have lots of access around here, and he can actually be very mobile. What is... What is this?
It's not me.
I can hear it's you. Oh, God. Is this a toilet snake?
Is this a toilet snake?
No, it's been in the sewer.
It's been in the sewer.
It's been in the sewer?
Yeah.
No, it's very clean.
Get it out of my room. And this is what I deal with on a daily basis.
Okay, so that didn't go over real well. We'll find some other trick that'll get us to make sure we can see his secret room in the future someday.
What have you done?
Oh, I'm sorry, Michael.
Demo is day two.
I know, but this is where the photo booth is going to go, and I'm off 9 inches. I need 6 inches back, and I can save it right here. It's going to fit. Beautiful 6 inches here. I'm going to extend the wall out here 3 inches, and the photo booth is going to sit right in here so it's flush.
You sure you got it covered?
Yeah, but do you want to help me? Give it a go?
The same time?
Ty's in Patrick Henry's room, so don't worry.
All right. Paul, you got a minute?
Yeah, Joe.
Good morning.
Morning.
You know, I was thinking about when we reveal the house to the family. Patrick's blind. He's not going to be able to see the house. I have a friend of mine, Tim, who's down at U of L. We're going to have him make a model of the house.
Cool. So Patrick will be able to like hold the house, put it on his lap and stuff?
I'd like you to go down there and look at it and see if you think that's going to work.
So Joe, our builder, had this great idea about building a house that looks just like the house that he had built for Patrick Henry. So when Patrick Henry and the bus pulled away, Patrick Henry would have something to feel, to see, to touch. He sent me to the University of Louisville to meet Tim, who was going to make that.
We actually got the 2D plans from Joe emailed to us. Damon read them into the computer and actually started creating all the walls, the cabinets, and everything that goes with that. When we're done with the physical prototype from that three-dimensional laser printer type equipment, everything will be there. It will be actually something you'd hold, touch, and feel.
These guys build this thing out of polymer plastics, I believe it was, and a machine that lasers it, and the process that goes into this is high technology. I mean, the things that these machines can now make are phenomenal.
Bring it by. You'll be there for when we move the bus, right?
Absolutely. We'll have it.
Bring it by. Are you going to come?
We'll be there.
Okay. Good minds.
Thank you.
See you guys.
Okay, Patrick, I've got to say, mate, it has been an absolute pleasure to be with you and your family this week.
Well, thank you. It's a pleasure to have been with you as well.
Now, I've worked out that you've been playing piano for your family for about 19 years, but I think it's only fair, being in London, that, you perform for my mum and dad and my little brother as well.
Oh, well, I'd love to. That would be wonderful.
Also, I think it's only fair that we let Ty and the guys in Kentucky know what we're about to do. You up for that?
Sounds good to me. Let's do it. All right.
Okay, here we go. You ready?
Okay.
Hello, Ty. Hello, guys. Hope you are all having a fantastic week in Kentucky and the house is coming along great. Now, you're joining me here in London's West End in one of the biggest and best theatres on stage with Patrick, because I didn't want you guys to miss out, because it's an absolute treat to watch this young man play. So without further ado, I give you Patrick Henry Hughes.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Patrick Henry sits down at the piano, he is at home. That is home for him. Music is so, so important to this family. It transcends so many things, and it's a passion that they all have, and it's a passion that can be shared without sight, without being able to see. And the irony is just unbelievable that a kid who can't reach out has reached out so far through his music and through his ability to not let a disability stop his dreams.
Thank you very much.
All right. Next year, and the year after.
All right. When Ed told us we were going to get 3 years of Disney Vacation Club,
getting sleep on early start. Yes. Ty apparently has got a fantastic surprise before he said.
The field is done! Nice job! You guys did an absolutely fantastic job. The field looks great. What do you say we tell Ty?
Okay, let's get a couple of babies.
Eight.
Let's put this down.
Good to see you again.
How are you? That's your art.
You worked very hard on this piece for about a month and a half.
It's really special that it's going.
I can't even for a minute that to somebody else put it in the house for the family. That's amazing. And it really touched me. I just hope that this story can inspire just one person, if not hundreds,
to come. This is very welcome.
Our home. Now, here's the news. Now you've got a great place to practice. Are you ready to see it? Woo! Hey! What do you think? So here's the thing. You guys
missing two kind of important members, aren't you?
Absolutely.
Right? Should we get them?
Those people would come to see me. You know, it's true that a lot of people will say that I inspire them, but really, I'm just a guy, just an ordinary guy living my life.
I know you guys are really excited about seeing your brand new house.
Yeah,
we'll show you that tomorrow, but I wanted to bring you back a little early because we've got something right here we want to show you.
Okay, cool. Let's go.
Let's see it.
We've been working. I know it's been a little struggle for you on the practice field.
Yes,
we've made some changes. Are you guys ready to see what we've done? Shelter so you can stay out of the sun. You don't have to worry about sweating to death. We've actually got some shade for you with it.
All right. Awesome.
My old field was generally a swamp. It was slow draining. If it rained, the rehearsal would probably have to be canceled. The new practice field for me and the marching band is wonderful, mainly due to the fact that I'll be able to participate more in the rehearsals.
Now, I know you are an incredible musician, and here in the band, you are an incredible trumpet player. Well, we thought an incredible trumpet player deserves an incredible trumpet.
Thank you very much.
Whoa!
I can't believe it. All right.
I had a few issues with my older trumpet with the valves. They weren't going up quick enough, but this trumpet, the valves are wonderful. It even produces a better tone. I was actually having a hard time with the old trumpet producing some of the higher notes on occasions, but now that was easier.
Band, you ready to practice?
Yeah!
Well then, let's practice!
The team and help out the band.
Yes. Okay, so there's one more thing I want to show you that I wanted you to actually feel.
Okay.
Now, feel right in front.
Inspired by Patrick Henry Hughes. Oh, my.
They travel games.
Oh, nice. I can't believe it.
Patrick Henry Hughes. No matter who uses that field, they'll know that that field was inspired by my.
Very excited.
All right! Yeah.
Bye, guys. We'll see you around.
Get out of that limo, and it's like, wow, this is all for our family. Just incredible. You know, you try to put it into words, they can't do it justice, but it's a magical moment, a magical moment.
You guys know what to say.
was not accessible for Patrick. It was a prison for him. And our new house, just seeing it on the outside, I knew it was going to be something that was going to give him freedom. It was so beautiful. It was more beautiful than anything you could ever imagine. And it's ours.
So do you guys like it?
I love it.
You guys love it, man. You got to give a big hug to these guys.
Absolutely beautiful.
So you can actually feel what the house is like.
Oh, the model of our house.
Cool.
Here's the front porch right here, Patrick.
The model of the house was a perfect replica of the outside of the house. And when I felt the model, it just excited me more, made me more anxious to open that door and have a look inside.
It has been a privilege and an honor to do this for you all. Now, we have a couple other things besides the house. Yesterday, we paid off the mortgage on your other house.
You now own this house
mortgage-free.
Oh.
Rocky, you want to tell them what else?
Thank you.
And because of the generosity of our community and the love for all of you all, we have a check for $100,000 for you all.
Oh, my goodness!
Now we got less than
There's people that are heroes to me. Patrick would be one of them. I really feel strongly that the Hughes family did not get as much out of this as we did. The relationships, the satisfaction, you know, we were the big winners. And it's something I'll never forget. And I already have it in my head that I'm going to pop in at another build somewhere and cheer that builder on and revisit some of the friendships.
Guys, walk through that door and into your brand new house.
All right.
Thank you.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
This is huge.
Look at this place.
Wow.
Somebody pinch.
I cannot believe this.
When I first walked through the front door of that home, of our home, it just took my breath away. Our old house was not wheelchair accessible. It was one disaster after another as far as just Patrick getting around in it. This new, beautiful home. The size of the house and the space for Patrick to move around in his wheelchair in. It's absolutely breathtaking. Just tremendous.
Wow.
Somebody pinch me. Wow.
Oh, wow. This is awesome.
Did you believe this?
There's a fireplace down here.
Oh, my goodness. I visualize almost like an extraordinary mansion when I think of my new house with everything within reach, and I could not believe it. I was just ecstatic. There were so many nice textile designs for me to feel, and that would also really help me know where exactly I'm going. It is a dream come true for me and possibly for everybody.
It is an after. I think he's been crying.
Getting y'all choked up, Patrick?
That's okay. There's Ty.
I can't believe it. It is amazing. Well, I'll tell you what, man. Michael really wanted to make sure you guys could hang out as a family. You know how important that is for you guys. So we make sure, you know, you have lots of room so Patrick Henry, you can get around easier. And, of course, you've got a brand new kitchen. Now, a lot has changed over here. You guys have got all new countertops. You've got stainless steel Kenmore Pro appliances.
Sweet.
This is a really cool feature, too, that I think you guys are going to dig. Sears totally hooked you guys up. And the really cool thing is they have this website called managemyhome.com. You put your model numbers in there. Let you know when it's time to change your filter. If you have a question about a repair or even another project, it's all right on a website.
I love to cook. I love my new kitchen. Sears has provided us with these appliances that are just amazing. And it's just truly a dream come true.
So if you start feeling right here, okay, so that's a picture frame, and then there's this quilt. It was made by this blind and deaf artist named Jesse. He wanted to send a message, too, and he really, because you really inspire him as well, and he wanted to make sure that people understand not to judge people by their disability, but to judge them by their ability.
That is so nice.
The quilt was really awesome. It just amazed me that, once again, that people are inspired by me, just a guy who's living a regular life, that even if I weren't such an inspiration, I'd probably live the same life anyway.
You guys like what you see so far?
Yeah.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Well, there's a lot more of this house to see, so I'll tell you what. Guys, go check out the rest of your house.
Oh, this is amazing. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my. Oh, look at the pictures. And wow, this is incredible. This is awesome. This is so cool. This is so incredibly amazing. Oh my gosh!
When I first walked into my room, I'm thinking, wow, I'm just gonna take pictures for the next 5 years. Just straight, that's all I'm gonna do. And when I saw that there's only one bed in that room, one bed. I've never seen a room with one bed. And to have my own room for the first time in my entire life was just incredible.
Dude!
This is so awesome!
Isn't this awesome?
Dee did such a good job on this.
Dude, she knew you love photography, man, so she gave you everything you need to be a photographer. You got a camera, obviously, right?
Got my new one.
And look at this.
I know. And
isn't this fantastic?
One, two, three, and four. All right.
There we go.
There we go.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, that was
my favorite right there.
Yeah.
That's nice.
I like that one. More natural.
I don't know. I think that's a keeper.
Look at it! Oh, it's a bed. Whoa. Somebody's playing guitar. That's pretty cool. Wow. Oh, I see what's making that noise now. It's the floor. Wow.
When I walked into the room, I was just amazed. I started running around looking at all the guitars, and I was like, whoa. The next time you see me, I'm probably going to be a guitarist.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
Beautiful picture.
Wow.
Wow, this is gorgeous. Oh, wow.
Wow.
Awesome.
Can you believe this place?
Is this beautiful or what?
This is beautiful. Look.
The bedroom is absolutely breathtaking. And I'm thinking, wow. You know, this is our personal sanctuary for my wife and I to have moments for ourselves, you know, away from the boys. We love the boys, but you need moments. You can't imagine, after the five of us hovering for space all these years, to, you know, how that makes me feel.
So what do you guys think?
It's
just
awesome.
Amazing, man.
It
Thank
is
you.
Amazing.
Just incredible.
It is.
I'm so happy for you guys.
We get two doors.
That's right.
And then I opened the bathroom door, and it was like it just kept going and going. You know, it's incredible.
Well, Michael wanted to give you guys
beautiful.
Michael wanted to give you guys something you guys never had, and you know, a place that's luxurious, a place where you guys can totally relax. Pretty cool, right?
Always,
you guys like the bed?
No, I love it.
Beautiful.
I absolutely love it.
Well, I'll tell you what. There are a few more things I want to show you that I think not only you guys are gonna like, but I think Patrick Henry's gonna like too.
Great.
Follow me.
All right.
Excited.
I just want to say this, man. I've been very excited to be working on your room this week. I know you are 19. I know you're in college. I know, like a lot of other people your age, you want your independence. And I'm hoping that the room that I've worked on is going to give you some of that independence back. So here's what I'd like you to do. I'd like you to go down to that hallway, to that door on the right, and literally say, open door.
All right.
Cool. You ready?
All right.
Go check out your room, Patrick.
Okay.
All right, you ready?
Open door!
There it goes.
Too cool.
Oh, my goodness. You are going to love this. It's an accessible apartment for Patrick Henry Hughes.
Oh man, that is sweet.
You have a kitchen on your left. Here's your refrigerator.
All right. Nice.
Your kitchen sink. Right, here's your faucet.
What a magnificent space for Patrick Henry. Patrick now has everything at his disposal that I could never have afforded. And some of the technology I couldn't even dream of. And here it is. As his dad, it's one of the happiest moments of my life.
Your accessible bathroom.
Oh.
You have a nice toilet in front of you.
Start with the commode.
The rails.
It's got rails around it that you can grab onto.
Oh, man, is that sweet.
Next is your sink.
To your right, you have your towel racks to your right.
Down there where you can reach them, huh?
Nice. Sweet.
My old bathroom was almost a fighter, wouldn't let me get in, so I'd have to rely on my parents, and sometimes, of course, they would have other things that they were doing, and I'd have to wait. My new bathroom, I can just go right in. The shower that I can wheel into is wonderful. If I wake up in the morning and just want to get in there, then I can do that.
So, Patrick Henry?
Oh, man, I can't believe this.
There's some cool stuff in here, man.
Yes.
Let me let you understand what this is.
Okay.
There's some really cool things I want to make sure you had in your room, okay?
All right.
This is one of them. Now, this is a recording studio. This is where you can record your own music.
Awesome.
Now, you can also compose it, and this computer will actually read it, print it out in Braille or in sheet music.
Oh, cool. My recording area in the new apartment is just excellent. I can't wait to finally learn how to use all the programs and maybe make a CD here pretty soon. A lot of people have said that I need to make, for example, Patrick Sings Christmas Songs. Now I'll be able to do that at my own leisure.
There's something to your right I want you to feel. This is a brand new wheelchair. It's an all-terrain wheelchair.
Oh, cool.
And it has sensors on it that actually let you know when you're about to run into something.
Oh. My goodness. Wait a minute. I got to get in this thing.
Let's get in here.
What the heck?
You ready to get in?
That is nice.
Okay. Now, here's what's really neat. Your controls are right in front of you here. So now you're going backwards. That's right.
Right.
This one makes you go forward.
This week has been about unconditional love, in my opinion. It's been about a father and you know, parents making the ultimate sacrifice of, like, really putting their life on complete hold and being there for their child no matter what. You know, you see a guy who overcomes challenges every single day, and, you know, I look at that kid and realize he's got so many talents none of us will ever have. He's a very special kid who has a true gift, and he can really change the world. When you hear him sing, you will believe. Patrick Henry, one of the most amazing young men I've ever met. Your parents are also some of the most amazing people I've ever met. I'm just glad we could do it, man.
Thank you.
We are forever grateful to you guys, all of you all. This is something that we will continue to earn, not just be given, but to continue to give back.
Well, you know what? I guess there's just one thing left to say. Welcome home, Hughes family. Welcome home.
Yeah!
All right! Patrick?
Yes?
Why don't you take us out of here, man? Let's hear this.
Old man really lived in that White House down the street where I grew up. Mama used to send me over with things. We struck a friendship up. Spent a few long summers out on his old porch swing.
We who have sight look upon Patrick Henry as a disabled person. We see a wheelchair. We see that he is blind. But he doesn't see that, nor does he feel that. And so to see this person go, I'm not disabled, I'm able. He is very able. I think Patrick Henry has touched many people's lives along the way for a long time. And we were honored just for a week to be in his presence.
And bow my head. I'm finding more and more truth. Words written in red. They tell me that there's more to life than just what I can see. Oh.
It makes me proud that I can say I was there. I was there the day Patrick Henry got his house, and I was a small part of that with hundreds of other people who made that happen, who came and really helped. And that's when we get it right. That's when we know we have it right, when you can stand there and be proud that you were part of that moment.
You know I'm more and more convinced the longer that I live. Yeah, this can't be. No, this can't be. No, this can't be all there is. Lord, I raise my hands.
My main message, not to just people my age, but to everybody, is that it doesn't matter what kind of disabilities you might have or what kind of problems you might face on a day-to-day basis. If you set your mind to achieve a goal, then you can do it.
I believe, oh, I believe, I believe.
Thank you.
To find out more about the products used on tonight's show, go to abc.com, keyword home makeover. The 50 states takes us to Virginia.
Good morning, Lucas family!
A National Guardsman called to duty leaves an unfinished dream behind.
My husband's in danger every day, and having all of this stuff in his mind is not helping him stay safe.
So we bring him back from Iraq to finish his mission at home.
To bring the soldier home to see his family, which he hasn't seen in ages, is going to be huge.
Why do you put your life on the line?
For love of this country.
And Toby Keith pays tribute to our troops.
That's a song I wrote to dedicate to all of you.
It was just the best homecoming, and it makes me proud to be an American soldier.
An all-new Brothers and Sisters starts right now on ABC.